This is an exciting time for me because every time I finish a painting, of course, it's exciting. But this is especially exciting because Conquering the Storms is a painting that has a lot of personal meaning to me. I have, for years, thought of lighthouses as being symbols of God's hope in the midst of storms. You know, the scripture tells us that we're to forget what lay behind and press on towards the goal. And I think of that scripture when I look at this painting, which reminds me, no matter what storms come our way, with God's help, we can conquer them. I've painted a number of lighthouse scenes over the years. I painted my first piece of a lighthouse was Beacon of Hope. That painting was very serene. It had a lot of sense of the ocean coming in, but it was more of a peaceful ocean. Then I went to Light in the Storm, and the ocean got a bit more dramatic. I did The Light of Peace, which featured breaking waves and a sense of light pouring from the sky. Then with Clearing Storms, I took on the task of presenting a storm that was kind of ending. Of course, the follow-up to that was a painting I did called Sea of Tranquility, which was my most recent lighthouse painting up until this one. And in that painting, of course, I tried to capture the ocean as a serene and very tranquil place of joy. Conquering the Storms is probably the most dramatic of all the lighthouse scenes I've ever done. It's also the biggest painting I've done of this subject. It's slightly bigger than The Light of Peace, which up till this time was my largest lighthouse painting. When I worked on this painting, I wanted that larger size because I wanted to get the drama of a sea. This is the sea in the opposite extreme from what we saw in Sea of Tranquility. This is the ocean where it surges and just has the energy of creation behind it. It has God's power unleashed upon the earth, so to speak. And yet, the storms are not frightening when you're founded on a rock. And that's very symbolic to me. Here's the lighthouse keeper's cottage, and it is made of the stones upon which it is built. The same stones that it sits upon were used to build the cottage itself. I love the sense of the octagonal lighthouse. It has a sense of planes to it that come around the surface. That gives a real sense of solidity to it. I wanted to really create two worlds. On the one hand, the storm in all its fury, and on the other hand, the serene peace that we can enjoy even in the midst of the storms. Now, let me tell you, when you go through a difficult time in life, as everyone does, each of us have, we need to know that we can conquer that storm with God's help. Now, it's not our own strength that gets us through. God will give us the strength to do it if we will take the step of faith, if we'll only trust Him one day at a time. Conquering the Storms is the first painting where I've painted the effect of lightning. And of course, I'm known as the painter of light, so naturally I want to try to represent every effect of light you see in nature. But in my entire career, I've never painted the effect of lightning. It was so fun to put that jagged line of the lightning as it flashes down to the horizon. And of course, we see a little boat that is out there on that storm-tossed sea. There's a great sense of the swelling waves in this painting. Now, most of the time when I have painted the ocean, I paint the big flat horizon that you see. But in this case, it's that swelling horizon of a true storm at its peak. The boat that we see going out in the horizon has a little light on it, and that was a fun touch to put there. I have a feeling of someone aboard, you know, perhaps fearful in the midst of the storm, and yet they have their little light burning, and of course they're looking out at the lighthouse on the horizon. There are seven ends in this painting, so you'll have fun finding each of them. I will tell you this, there is a hidden end on one of the waves, and see if you can find that. When I hide the ends, I always think of some imaginative place to put an end that is different perhaps than others I've done. My wife Nanette commented when she first saw this painting that she loved the effect of the trees almost bending in the breeze and the sense that the wind is carrying away that smoke coming up out of the chimney of the little cottage. Evidence that the wind is buffeting, the storm is blowing, and yet there in the midst of all that is the stability, the safety that we see up on the high ground of that rock. I also really enjoyed the different types of trees. I put a lot of different foliage touches into the painting that I think brought out a sense that this is a cozy place to live, even in the midst of a storm. I love painting the effects of sunset light. it was especially fun to see the light flashing out at the horizon from the clouds almost spilling forth. There's a sense that the storm will eventually break up and all will be calm again. But right now, in the midst of the storm, we still see a quiet, peaceful world over here as we look at the lighthouse and the little cottage beside it. I had a friend look at this painting in my studio and say, you know, I just feel like two worlds are being depicted. The world of storms that we see sometimes in our life, and yet the world of peace. A sense of overriding peace, even in the midst of the storm. And I got asked recently why paintings can be so profoundly compelling to people. I mean, people can put these works in their home and get touched by it in such a way that it can actually change their life. We've had story after story, testimony after testimony of people who've had amazing life experiences where their life really has been touched, and in part due to the painting. Well, of course, it's not the painting. A painting can't really change a life. But I think a painting can be a symbol of hope for someone. And I always say it becomes part of the family. It's not just decoration on the wall. It becomes part of the family culture. And so in my mind, at least, I think of this painting as one that will really probably have a lot of impact in people's lives. I know it even changed my life as I was working on it. We were going through some difficult things with children, as often happens, where you're working through issues. And yet, as I was working on that painting, I kept thinking to myself, wait a minute, I can conquer the storm with God's help. And so it ministered to my heart as I was painting the work. So I'm really convinced God will use this painting in a lot of people's individual lives, perhaps to give them a little hope, but also to give them strength, to remind each of us that with God's help, we can conquer every storm. God bless you.
For personal viewing of this latest painting or other works by Thomas Kinkade, please contact your local gallery